Thank you. All right, welcome back to the Accountability Project, where we condense the pain of personal growth and development. So today, in the tongue, the creative force, we're talking about the ability of the tongue. And ultimately what this chapter is breaking down is how the words we speak, the power, the creative power of our tongue, the words that we use, are able to manifest in the physical world because of their power in the spiritual world, and that we have the ability to speak over the spirit of man because our words are coming from the Word of God. They're the words of the Spirit being spoken into spiritual man, and so things are manifest in the physical man once we take hold of that spiritual dominance over the physical. And it's a little bit complicated, and I'm not quite sure I fully understand how this process works, only that it does work, and that the spiritual realm is supreme to the physical realm, and that whatever we bind or loose in the spiritual, there are ramifications in the physical. Very similar to the concepts behind the idea of the power of attraction, that whatever we emanate out is what we attract, has a spiritual element to it. In this sense, we're talking about physically speaking. If we're speaking, stand up and take up your bed and walk with the belief of knowing that the healing will happen, we're speaking spiritual healing over the physical body. And that's a very powerful concept. And then in the five love languages today, we talked about physical touch and the different dialects of physical touch. That can be everything from intercourse to holding hands, to kissing, to brushing up against each other in the kitchen. And that everyone's touch dialect may mean different things. So the power of a hug even is going to have a significant difference to someone whose love language is touch versus someone who isn't. Not that a hug isn't typically appreciated, but for someone who their love language is physical touch and that's their dialect, it can have massive ramifications. And even more so, the withdrawal of physical touch is representative of the withdrawal of your love for someone who that is their love language. And this is very important for spouses to remember that if your spouse's love language is physical touch and you withdraw from physical touch because you're hurt or offended by something, oftentimes that can lead to more problems because now you're telling them that you don't love them, when in reality you wanted to tell them, I'm hurt by something you did and we need to have a conversation to fix this. You're expressing through your actions because of their love language that you no longer love them, and that causes more tension in a relationship. So I'm excited to go into the rest of this book, which we're going to start looking at how to identify your love language as well as your spouse and how to communicate across love languages. So fired up about this book. It's a great refresher for me to going back through and re-listening. Me and my wife actually had some great dialogue the other day. Because our love languages sometimes shift as we grow and mature and have different life experiences. And for instance, my love languages have shifted some. I'm still predominantly words of affirmation, but I'm also very big on acts of service. That's a huge, huge love language for me. And my wife is used to be predominantly quality time and touch as a secondary. And now she's very, very much feeling like gift, as well as words of affirmation, as well as acts of service. My wife is an anomaly. She has like all five, and based on which ones I am not providing, tends to be the one that she feels the need for the most. So it's important to keep a dialogue going with your spouse, and reassessing what is the love language you have, which of your love tanks needs more love and attention focused on it. So with that, this has been the Accountability Project. We love you. We appreciate you. Condense the pain of personal growth. Bloop.